Right, just another quick video. Most of you all know that I need, obviously, knee replacement in the right knee, full knee replacement, partial knee replacement, and possibly cruciate grafts, etc., in the left knee. I have a date for the first knee replacement, and I know there's a few people that have said I would keep informed with regards to it, and that it's looking like it's going to be the last week of July, the first week of August. And then hopefully from there, it's going to be the recovery period, and then there's going to be the left knee. But then hopefully after that, actually try and get back on track for everything that I want to do. But yeah, here's an interesting one for you. I just thought everyone likes bruises. Over the weekend, while moving a large 1000cc bike out of the barn to get to another bike, which I'm gonna end up riding, which is a FMX, Honda FMX 650 Supermoto, or Sumo, the Americans call it. But yeah, I dropped the 1000cc bike on my leg, which when you've got knackered knees, didn't do me any favours. Some quite decent sized bruises there, which are not really, you can kind of see it, but that's all green. Yeah, and then on the Saturday night, this is the bad knee. I see the bruising. I managed to get stood on, and it hyperextended the knee in the same direction that I originally broke it. So I had a bit of a scare and had to spend a while in A&E having x-rays, and I've got to go to the knee clinic to make sure I've not done any further damage to the ACL. And then depending on what they say, I might have to go to Birmingham. But I don't think I will. I don't think I will. But either way, luckily there was no break in the bone. But yeah, that's it's quite a weekend for knees. Some funny looks walking about today. Black and blue legs. But yeah, I said I'd keep a few people informed. So I do actually have the date for the first knee, or a hypothetical date for the first knee replacement, which is going to be last week of July, first week of August, and then hopefully try and get everything back on track. So I know a lot of people have been waiting more than patiently for stuff since coming off the painkillers, which you've got to come off the painkillers before they'll do a knee replacement. Something to do with this, well, this is a kind of a guess, something to do with the need, the nerves, because the painkillers I was taking were all nerve blocking, or femoral injections, which are nerve blocking. They need the nerves to be firing at 100% to regenerate the muscle growth and the tissue growth around the bone, and at least that's what I guess. So it's been a very difficult couple of weeks, months, yeah. So there is progress on that. Like I said, promised I would keep everybody informed. So there you go.